Now we are going to discuss question number 19. The two waves are given in the form of E1 equals to E0 1 x cap cos 2 pi mu z by c minus t, and this wave is in air, and another wave is E0 2 x cap cos k 2z minus ct in medium, right? And it's given that k is the wave number and mu is frequency corresponding or referring the wave in air. What we have to find? We have to find the ratio of the relative permittivity of air and medium. So we know this wave, the standard format of this wave is given as E equals to amplitude E naught cos kz minus omega t for any medium, right? And if the velocity of the wave in that medium is v, then v can be written as omega upon k. So if we will follow this wave equation, we will just try to compare this standard format with the format that has been given over here, and we will find the velocity of the wave in both the medium, that is in air and in some medium. So for air, if you compare this particular equation with this, we can write k, that is a wave number, equals to 2 pi mu upon c, and omega equals to 2 pi mu, right? So the velocity in air will be omega upon k, and that will be equals to c. Okay, now we'll compare, we'll find the velocity for medium. For medium, the value of k is equals to, let's call it k dash. So k dash will be equal to 2 times k, that is 2 times of the wave number in air, and let's call it omega dash. Omega dash will be k into c. Alright. So velocity in medium will be omega dash upon k dash, and that will be kc upon twice k, and that will be c by 2, right? So we got the velocity in air as well as velocity in medium. Now let us assume that n1 and n2 refractive index of air and medium, right? So we can write n1 into v1 is equals to n2 into v2, right? So n of air upon n of medium is equals to v of medium upon v, velocity in air. So what will be the answer? Velocity of medium is c by 2 upon c. So this will be equals to half. All right, and we know that relative permittivity is directly proportional to n square, right? So for this, if I write ER1 upon ER2, epsilon R1 upon epsilon R2, we'll just square this. So this will be equal to 1 by 4. So the ratio of the refractive index is square root of the ratio of their corresponding relative permittivity, right? So the correct option is option 1.
Explore more about the topics you love with Topper. Subscribe now and keep learning.